sympathy has been going on across northern Uganda since the news broke out about the ill health of the Speaker of Parliament. Right now, the National Fellowship of Born Again Pentecostal Churches of Uganda have organized prayers for his quick recovery.
The prayers attracted Christians who believe that the Speaker's illness needs spiritual intervention.
The caliber of Jacob Olanya is very important because if you look at the hierarchy in our country, he's number three and the Speaker of the entire country. So when a person like this is very sick and lots of things are being said and there are lots of talks around, we as men of God have a key role to play, and that role is to pray for such people and bring sanity in the community.
We're going to pray for the family to stand strong and trust God who is able to heal him. But also we are praying for the Parliament of Uganda, the place where he worked, because at such a time also they need his participation.
On the 6th of February, reports emerged that the Speaker of the 11th Parliament, Jacob Olanya, was flown to Seattle for treatment.
Prayers come barely 48 hours after the DP President General Norbert Mao came out to criticize the opposition in Uganda and those in the diaspora for their demonstrations about the money that was spent to take Jacob Olanya for specialized treatment in the United States of America.
Olanya had chosen to die in his own house. I went and saw Olanya. I saw Olanya with pipes all over him. He said, I'm going to stay here. If nobody can take care of me, let me die.
An angry Norbert Mao called opposition politicians night dancers for questioning the 5 billion shillings that is believed to have been spent by the government of Uganda to airlift Jacob Olanya to the USA.
Olanya did not beg for anybody's money. It is the Chief Justice Owindolo who started mobilizing us one by one. Called the Deputy Speaker, called the Clerk to Parliament. And then I remember there was the Deputy Speaker calling the President. Olanya said, it is okay if other people can be treated better than me. He was ready for us to pick his body from his house. So it is extremely painful knowing how much money the government has spent in treating other people. We must fight back against that kind of negativity.
However, in the prayers held today at the compound of the Gulu District Headquarters, Pentecostal Bishop Dr. James Ochan urged Ugandans to unite and render spiritual uplifting to the beloved Speaker of Parliament.
Naturally, we are very optimistic that the Right Honorable Speaker of Parliament, Jacob Olanya, begins to receive his healing today. I also want to inform the citizens of Uganda that when somebody is sick, the only thing that person needs from you and me is courage and support. A sick person does not need criticism.
The Right Honorable Jacob Olanya replaced his former boss Rebecca Alitwala Kadaga as the Speaker of Parliament in 2021.
The health condition of the Speaker is still unknown, but according to the information that we got from the DP President, he is recovering.
Meanwhile, Deputy Speaker Anita Among today said Olanya's health has greatly improved. She updated that he has been able to speak to some MPs and thanks God for his progress. Olanya has not been in Parliament ever since plenary sittings resumed after the festive season. Okay.